Everybody, my name is Rupa, working as assistant professor in Chevrolet Engineering College. I'm dealing the subject electrical machines too, and today's topic in the is in alternators. We are dealing about control of real and reactive powers. Okay, so until now we have seen the distribution of load. So how we are getting unequal voltages, what is the effect of unequal voltages we have seen through. And now on the for the distribution of load, what are the consequences we are about to occur face. So first one is already we have seen effect of change in excitation. Next to second one, effect of change in screen supply. So for the effect of change in excitation, we have increased the excitation of one machine, and we see that the alternator one is increased, it has increased excitations. If you increase the excitation, and see now coming to the effect of change in screen supply, suppose that excitations we have kept same. So for here in the change of screen supply, we are keeping the excitations constant. For both the alternators, we are keeping the excitations equal. Okay, but screen supply to the alternator one we are increasing. That is how we increase the screen supply. If you increase the power input to the prime mover, then the screen supply will be increased, right? So the for the prime mover, we are increasing the screen supply one. Okay, so for one alternator we are increasing the prime mover's input. So as the speeds of the two machines we are tying each other, that means we are making that speeds of the speeds of the two machines we are tied together, that means we are making to run the machines, two alternators, to run the two alternators at the same speed, we are seeing that. So for this we are tying them to the same shaft. So if one alternator will be rotating with one speed, then the second alternator will be automatically rotating with the speed of the first alternator. So as the two machines are tied together, they synchronous bond, there will be a synchronous bond. So this first machine, it cannot overcome the second machine, because as they are tied together, though we increase the steam supply to the first alternator, it cannot run with more speed than the second alternator. Okay, but alternately this will be utilizing the increased power input for carrying more load than two. So what is the advantage of increasing the steam supply for alternator one? Though it is not running at the same though it is not running with the input given to the prime mover, but it can carry more load than second alternator. It is the only advantage. So this can be also made possible only when alternator one rotors advances its angular position with respect to alternator 2. So see here in the figure 37.93, if the rotor of alternator 1 makes an advanced angular position, means it the angular position of rotor 1 is changed to advanced position, then the alternator 2. So when it makes the advanced position in the angular position, advanced angular position rather than alternator 2, here even is also get advanced. Even the EMF voltage of alternator 1 will also get advanced. Okay, so here even will be getting advanced than E2 by an alpha, angle alpha. Okay, so the resultant current voltage, see here ER, the resultant voltage actually same. If you give equal excitations, if you give equal steam supply, these both alternators will be rotating at same speeds and they are delivering the same EMFs E1 and E2. See here, this is the phasor diagram regarding the equal excitations, steam supply and equal speeds A. And coming to B here, E1 is the EMF of first rotor is advanced by an angle alpha for E2. Okay, so the resultant will be ER. Okay, so this resultant ER, it is also called as ESY. It is produced on the load circuit and it is setting a current ISY. This will be ISY will be lagging almost 90 degrees behind ER. And it will be in phase with ER, E1. In phase, that means as E1 is there, ISY will be there. That means E1 and ISY will be in phase because this is the first rotor. This is due to the first rotor current. So it will be almost 90 degrees ahead by ER and almost in phase with E1. Okay, so now the power per phase for machine 1, I am increasing. How much I am increasing? E1 into ISY. What is the power I am increasing for machine 1? Alternator 1, power E1 into ISY. So, the power for machine 1 is increased. So, the power for machine 2 will be decreased. And it is decreased by same amount what the amount it is increased for alternator 1. If you increase the alternator 1 power by 10 watts, the same 10 watts is decreased in alternator 2. Okay, so as we know that here ISY, it is a reactive component. This increases the steam supply only and it does not distribute the division of reactive powers. Only it increases the active power output of alternator 1. And it decreases the active power output of alternator 2. Okay, so after we have increased the excitation for 1, load division when steam supply is getting more to alternator 1. That means when we increase the steam supply to alternator 1, the load division is seen in figure C here. Okay, see here. This is for 1 and this is for 2 load division. So, this is heavy one, this is large one, and for 2, it is low. So, see here, I am summarizing the points. When you increase the input to the prime mover, alternator is made to take greater share of the load. Okay, and the power factors will also be different. So, what are the points to be remembered? Our first one is, so, see here, we are increasing the steam supply to 1. So, the load taken by the alternator, it will be directly depending upon the torque. And it will be directly depending upon the angular advance, this one alpha. Angular advance of the rotor. So, how much we are giving the steam supply and how much the angle is advanced, even is advanced by E1 is advanced for E2 by an angle alpha. Okay. E1 is advanced by an angle alpha by for E2. Right. So, this angle decides the how much load taken by E1 and E2. That is alternator 1 and alternator 2. Okay. And if you change the excitation, actually it will be changing the power factor. And the load delivered will be without affecting the load also. So, this is possible as long as the steam supply is unchanged. Okay. And third one is, if the input to the prime mover is kept constant, that is, if the input to any alternator prime mover is kept constant, but if you change the excitation, then KVA component of the output is changed, not the KW. Reactive power will be changed, not the active power. You know that power is reactive and active power. Okay, KVA component means reactive power, KW means active power. So only reactive power will be changed, not the active powers. So these all about the theories in the alternators. Now we will go for problems. So see here, first problem. Calculate the distribution factor for a 36 slots 4 pole single layer 3 phase winding. Okay, so see, we have to find the distribution factor. What is the formula for distribution factor? Kd is equal to sin m beta by 2 by m sin beta by 2. Now we have to find this beta value and m value, right? So m value and beta value, see here, for m value and beta value, see, first you have to find how many slots are divided per pole. Okay, first we have to divide n. We have to find n. N is nothing but how many slots are divided per one pole. Suppose there are 36 slots in this problem and 4 poles. So under each pole, how many slots comes? 36 by 4. Under each pole, 9 slots will be divided. So each pole, one pole will be sharing 9 slots. Okay. First 1 to 9, one pole. 9 to 18, second pole. 18 to 27, third pole. 27 to 36, fourth pole. So like that, each pole will be dividing slots. If each pole will be allocating slots. Okay. So that is called as n. N is equal to 36 by 4. So for any problem, we have to calculate n, m, beta, alpha. These four we have to, there is need to calculate. Okay. So see the procedure. For n calculation, how many slots are divided per each pole is nothing but n. So n is equal to, in this problem, 36 by 4. That is 9. Okay. Now, beta means, see here, beta means, I'm again explaining because so long ago we have seen the theory. Beta. Beta means each slot, the difference between the each slot, what is the angle? Okay, so every slot contains copper, right? So in copper is distributed in every slot. So we are having round slots throughout the armature circular. Okay, so what is the angle between each slot, side by side slot? That is nothing but beta. So how will we calculate beta means 180 by 9. What is pitch factor, full pitch? If the angle between the slots is 180. If the angle between the slots is 180, that means if a copper wire will be running from first slot, it should be distributed into the slot such that the difference between the slots will be 180. Then only we will say that it is a full pitch. Right? Suppose, see here. This is first slot, this is second slot, this is third slot, fourth slot, fifth slot. Okay, so first, second, third, fourth, fifth. Okay, so we are taking copper wire into each slot, right? We are taking the copper wire into each slot. See here, what is full pitch? Suppose the angle between the two slots, see here, this is nothing but beta, right? What is the angle between the two slots? Nothing but, that is called as beta, right? So suppose I am telling that the angle between the first and second slots is 30 degrees. Okay, so if one slot has 30 degrees, every slot has a difference of 30 degrees only. There will be no change in the angle difference. Okay, so there will not be any possibility of difference of angles, because if the difference between the first and second slot is 30, then the difference will be difference between the second and third slots will also be 30, not 20. Okay, so all the differences will be equal. Okay, so 30, see here 30. So see here, up to 3, up to third slot, what is the angle difference? 60, right? 30 plus 30, 60. Next, here again, 30 degrees will be there. Again, 60 plus 30, 90. Right? Up to the fourth slot, what is the angle difference? 30, 30, 30, 90. Okay? Again, 4 to 5. Again, the difference is 30, right? Now, what is the difference up to fifth slot? 120 degrees, right? 430 is 120. 30 plus 30 plus 30 plus 30. So, up to fifth slot, the angle is 120. And next, considering sixth slot. So, again, the fifth and sixth slot is having a beta difference of 30 degrees, right? So, see here, up to now, what is the angle? Total angle 180, right? We got 180. Okay, 30 plus 30, 60, 60 plus 30, 90, 90 plus 30, 120, 120, sorry, 120 plus 30, 150. Again, you have to add extra slot, sorry. Seventh slot. So, 150. Again, 150 plus 30, 180. So, up to now, we are getting up to seventh slot. What is the slot angle? 180 degrees. Right? Did you understand the difference? 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, total 630 is 180. Okay? So, see here. Now, I am telling about full pitch and short pitch. See here. If I am taking a copper winding, So, this is one turn of copper winding. This is first turn. This is second turn of copper winding. Right? So, I have to place this in slots. If I place this first turn in first slot, I am placing this first turn in first slot. And where I have to place this second turn to get full pitch? Because, see here, I have to place, I already placed the first turn. This is turn one of coil. I have already placed this in first slot. Okay? I am placing this copper wire first turn in first slot. See here, in which slot I have to place this second turn so that there exists a 180 difference, that is called as full pitch. Okay? So, if the angle between the first turn and second turn is 180 degrees, then it is called as full pitch. So, see here, in order to get the full pitch, where I have to put the second turn? In 7. Like this, I have to place the copper coil. Do you understand? First turn, I have to place in first slot means second turn in order to get the full pitch. That means 180 degrees angle between the first and second turns. I have to place the second turn in the seventh slot. Then only it is called as full pitch. Okay. So, did you know about the beta? Beta 30 degrees. This beta is nothing but 30 degrees here. Okay, next, see here, what is short pitch? What is short pitch? Instead of keeping the second turn of coil in seventh slot, if I kept in sixth slot only, if I end the turn at sixth slot only, what happens? The angle is less than 180. The angle between the one and two turns is less than 180. Then it is called as short pitch. So, how much it is short pitch? 1. Okay. So, 1, 2, 3, 1. Difference is slots. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Total is 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. So, now that it is shorted by 1 pitch. Okay. So, it is termed as 5 by 6 short pitch. Okay, in problems I will explain that clearly. So, see here, what is short pitch? If the angle between the coil turns 1 and 2 is less than 180 degrees, then it is called as short pitch. If the angle between the 1 and 2 coils is 180, then it is called as full pitch. Okay, so what is beta? The angle between the two slots. Okay, how we calculate 180 divided by n? 180 divided by n, you will get for beta. Okay, so see the problem now. N, you know, how many poles are? Each slot, how many poles are divided? That is n. Now, beta means 180 divided by n. The formula is 180 divided by n. So, 180 divided by 9, that is 20 degrees. So, the difference between the each slot is 20 degrees. So, now what is m? M means, here n is number of slots per pole, right? N is number of slots per pole. What is m is? Number of slots per pole per phase. Okay, that is per phase, how much n? That is the value of n divided by phases. How many phases we are taking? That is value of m. Okay, n by phases. So here we are given three phase, right? Three phase. So n, what is the value of n? 9. 9 by 3, that is equal to 3. These are the values of n, beta and m. Now we have to find out the distribution factor Kd. Kd, what is the formula? Sin m beta by 2 by m sin beta by 2. That is equal to m is 3, beta is 20 degrees. We have to substitute the values. You will get distribution factor as 0.96. So always remember that this Kd will be always less than 1. Okay, you have to get the value always less than 1. If you get the value greater than 1, then it is the wrong answer. Next, second problem. A part of an alternator winding consists of 6 coils in series, each coil having a EMF of 10 volts RMS. It is induced in it. 10 volts of RMS is induced in each coil. So these coils are placed in successive slots, and between each slot and the next, there is an electrical phase difference of 30. That means beta is given as 30. Find graphically or by calculation the EMF of the 6 coils in series. What is the EMF of the 6 coils in series, which are placed in series? We have to find out. Okay, so first, for that, see here, first for that we have to find out Kd, nothing but vector sum of Kd. So before we go into the problem, I have explained to you at the time of distribution factor Kd, sum of vectors, right? So sum of vectors, same formula is applied here. See here, by given data, we can see that beta is equal to 30 degrees. And m, what is the value of slots that are divided in series? That is 6 coils in each. So m is taken as 6 here. And now Kd, we know the value of beta and m. So we can finally find out the value of Kd. Kd is equal to sine m beta by 2 by m sine beta by 2. That is equal to sine 90 degrees by 6 into sine 15 degrees. That is equal to some value. Keep it without calculation. Next, arithmetic sum. We have to, for EMF, we have to do the arithmetic sum and vector sum. So for arithmetic sum, see here, we are having each of 10 holes. How many? 6. So what is the arithmetic sum? Simply it is 6 into 10, 60 volts. Now what is the vector sum? In vectors we have to calculate. So we have to calculate the vector sum in terms of arithmetic sums, right? So if you multiply the arithmetic sum with Kd, you will get the vector sum. So Kd means that is equal to value 1 by 6 into 0.2588 into 60 volts. That is equal to 38.64 is the vector sum. Next, third problem. find the value of KD problems. If you know the concept, problems will be very easy. So first find out the concept. If you don't know the concept, and if you want to repeat the concept of different values like KC, pitch factor, full pitch, basic definitions and basic concept you have to know for the problems, right? So formulas you can by heart anyway, but you have to know the concept for doing the problems. So if you are not thorough with the concept, you can message me. I will go through once. Okay. So first, fourth problem. Find the value of KD for an alternator with 9 slots per pole. So what is that 9 slots per pole means, which is given for the cases. See here, first case, one winding in all slots. We are keeping one winding in all the slots and one winding only the first 2/3 of the slot per pole. And third bit, 3 equal windings placed sequentially in 60 degrees group. Okay, so see here, we have to calculate N, M, beta. Okay, so see here, what is the value of N here? 9 slots per pole. Slots per pole means it is nothing but N, right? 9 slots per pole. So beta, what is the value of beta? 180 degrees by N. That is equal to 180 degrees by 9. That is equal to 20 degrees. So each slot is having a difference of 20 degrees beta. And value of M. So we have to find out first the value of M for 9, 6 and 3 respectively. Right? So see here. First bit, one winding in all slots. That means M is equal to 9. So M is equal to 9 means beta is equal to 20. You have to find KD. That is equal to 0.64. You have to substitute the value of M and beta in KD. Next, one winding using only the first 2/3 of the slots per pole. Okay, only out of 3 you are using 3. Sorry, 2. Out of 3 you are using 2. So see here, you are having total 9. Okay. So first out of 3 you are using only 2. Like that, if 9 are taken, see, 6, 7, 8, 9. So only out of 3, only 2 are using here. So in first slot, 2. Second, 2. Third, 2. How many you are getting total? 6. 2, 2, 2, 6 you are getting. So M is 6 there. Right? So M is equal to 6 and beta is equal to 20. So same formula, substitute. And see here. 3 equal windings placed sequentially in 60 degrees group. Okay. So here it is given. M is equal to 3. Placed in 60 degrees group means no bother about 60. Okay. So beta is equal to 20 and M is equal to 3. Substitute, you will get the value of K. So if you observe KD here, at each time you are getting less than 1. Observe. And if you get more than 1, it seems that your substitution is wrong or your calculation is wrong. Check once. Okay, next problem. An alternator has 18 slots per pole and the first coil will be lying in slot 1 and 16. Okay, first coil lies in slots 1 and 16. Calculate the pitch factor for first one fundamental, third second one third harmonic, third one fifth harmonic, and fourth one seventh harmonic. So just multiply with the fundamental formula. If you are having the fundamental formula, just multiply with 3, 5, and 7 for the bits. So see here. So the first coil slot is, see here, it is in first slot, first turn. and second term is in 16th. Okay, second term in 16. Okay, so see here, actually the coil span, what is the coil span? The span between the first and second turn is nothing but coil span. Okay, so if you calculate the coil span here, 16 minus 1, you will get 15 slots. Okay, 16 minus 1, 15 slots. That is the coil span. So see here, actually, what is the full pitch here? 18. 18 slots are there, total 18 slots per pole. Okay, what is the full pitch? If the coil span is 15 slots, then it is fall by 3 slots. Out of 18, it is only in 15. Coil span is 15. So how many slots it is for reduced? 3 slots. So here alpha is equal to 180 into how many slots it is fallen by? 3 by 18. So total slots. What is the value of alpha? We have to find out the pitch factor, Kc. What is the formula? Kc. Kc is cos alpha by 2, right? Kc is cos alpha by 2. Okay, so we have to find Kc. See here, for Kc, we have to find cos alpha by 2. That is alpha we have to find. What is the value of alpha? 180 into how many slots it is fallen by, divided by total slots. That is the value of alpha. Here we get the alpha as 30 degrees, right? 30 degrees. So cos alpha means cos 30 degrees. So see here, alpha, put the value of alpha here. Kc1, for first one, actual normal formula is used. Kc is cos alpha 1. Sorry, cos alpha by 2. Okay, so fundamental means first. Alpha is 1 alpha. Okay, for fundamental, we are treating it as just alpha. That is 1 into alpha. So cos alpha by 2, cos 30 by 2. That is fundamental first bit. Second bit, they are asking for third harmonic. So cos 3 alpha by 2, just multiply with 3. 5 alpha by 2, just multiply with 5. Cos 5 into alpha by 2. Nothing but cos 1 into 15, cos 3 into 15, cos 5 into 15, like that. Cos 7 into 15. If they ask about the 11th harmonic, cos 11 into 15. Right? See here, if you observe the Kc here, Kc, what are you seeing here in Kc? This Kc value is also always less than 1. If you observe the Kc, Kc's value is also always less than 1. So Kd is always less than 1 and Kc is always less than 1. Okay. And remaining problems we will see in next classes.